This girl is using her body to feed the insects. She also uses them to write a story about the insect's history. Until one day, her body starts to rot. She is so miserable. This man is reading many medical books to find a way to save her. He accidentally releases the book insects out. They are moving all over the floor. The entire library is now terrifyingly invaded by insects. The man is also possessed by them, but he is not an ordinary person. He, Kano, was born with an ability to see stranger insects parasitizing on human body. He was born an orphan, then was adopted by an insect master. They lived happily and so closely. They traveled and killed many dangerous insects to save people. But it did not last long. One day, Kano's master was immersed in insects. He was stuck in a lake and about to die. He knew that he could not get out of this place, and his life would not last longer for sure. Before dying, he used his last strength to pull Kano into his lap. He wanted to save Kano from the dangerous creatures. He took one of Kano's eyes to pay for his life. Since then, Kano's teacher was gone. His hair turned white after just one night. Once again, he lost his last family. He later became a new insect master and changed his name to Naga. Naga goes to the mountain. He does not care about the world anymore. Whenever he sees insects harming people, he will save them. Naga uses his special ability to keep a peaceful life for both human and environment. That day, there is some strange things in the town where Naga stays. All the residents have insects living on their bodies. Naga takes out a magnifier. He carefully checks inside a resident's ear. Afterwards, he opens the drawer and gets a packet of powder. After pouring it into the water, he pours the mixture into the ear. A blue liquid is coming out of the ear. Finally, that farmer is healthy as usual. It turns out that all the people here are parasitized. Their left ears are deaf. Some people also have horns on their heads. They hear weird sounds around them every day. Only death can set them free. When Naga is sitting in the room, he sees a bunch of insects are surrounded in a dark corner. A man tells him that they are worms similar to snails. They usually live in the forest and use their sound to fascinate others. However, the thick snow makes them lose their sound. Hence, they move to this village. There is a little girl that is not like the other residents. Her both ears are not only affected, but her head also has some horns. These four horns help her hear a special sound. This sound cannot be heard by normal people. She has lived miserably with pain and danger. Her mother, who could not stand this, passed away. After her mother's death, she has nothing. She kept one of his mother's horns to remember her. She puts it on her forehead every day to commemorate. But she did not notice that she was possessed by the insects. Naga eventually discovers their hiding place. He uses his body, letting the parasites live on it. During that time, Naga has found a way to save the girl. He breaks the horn of the girl mother. She suddenly falls into a coma. A horn on her head falls down too. Hence, the girl recovers back to her normal health. She is no longer having a connection with her dead mother. Naga begins a new journey. He follows the signals left to conduct his investigation. One day, he is attacked by the insects after opening a book. The book bugs start moving. They are moving around and all over the library. They gradually surround Naga. Coincidentally, Hari comes up. She uses a pair of iron chopsticks to seal the bugs. She locks them in the paper. Naga is luckily saved by Hari. Actually, Naga used to go to Hari's house because he felt the signal of the insects. Hari used to be seriously parasitized by the insects. To save Hari, Naga risked his life and used the body to do experiment. Hari's servant told Naga that there was a blind insect master long time ago. She told Hari and her about the insect signal. That year, the husband of this master wanted to save their crop. He sneakily brought alcohol to the wood to lure them. Although the field was then saved, the farmer consequently got a punishment. Because alcohol was the origin of insect, it was something that human must not touch. The water rapidly turned into a swamp. There was a strange black creature living there. The dark water took away her husband and her son. Therefore, she decided to stay there. Later, as an endeavor to get rid of the insects, she got a dip in that black water. She was possessed by these creatures. Her eyes were blinded. Afterwards, she sent someone to find Hari. She hoped Hari could use her power to seal these dangerous insects. But the cost for this was that Hari was parasitized by them. Now, if Hari wants to be alive, she has to use the bugs to write a book. That book is about the insect's origin, so that they could sleep permanently. After writing, Hari can recover. But she does not know that the creatures are too cruel. Hari's body is soaked in the bath. They use a knife to cut her arm, then the black blood flows out. The insects then get weaker and weaker, they are losing their lives. After this experience, Naga knows more about the insects. His next destination is the original alcohol place. There will be many challenges on his upcoming journeys. That is the end of the movie. Thank you very much for watching. See you later.